A Western Sydney mother has described the terrifying moment she and her daughters were forced to take shelter as gunmen stormed an Auburn gym, shooting at a Comanchero kingpin and his brother. Today, police revealed they may have found the murder weapon, but community leaders fear authorities have lost control of the streets.
The image of a blood-soaked floor of a packed gym reception with two men dying still haunts those who were trapped inside.
I continually heard gunshots. Everyone's running. Everyone's just running to the back.
Shadia and her two teenage daughters were working out at the time but in separate areas. When all hell broke loose, Shadia feared her girls had been shot.
I kept calling them. They wouldn't answer. That broke me. I couldn't get through to them. And I'm like, my girls, where's my girls?
Fortunately, the girls had escaped with others by smashing a glass back door. Shadia was crawling along the floor and waiting to die.
I could envision being shot through the back. I don't know at that time what's happening. I don't know if it's a drive-by, if it's a siege.
As we now know, the targets of the shooters were brothers Omar and Comanchero boss Tarek Zahed. Both suffered multiple gunshot wounds. Omar could not be revived. Tarek has somehow survived.
Obviously been shot in the head and sustained horrific injuries. So his long-term prognosis is unknown.
The shooting's now also a political war, with police accused of losing their grip of the streets.
Could you imagine the terror of being in the gym with your children, hearing gunfire?
I am concerned about it. This behaviour of gang violence has no place in our society or our state.
Shadia says there were small children in the crèche right next to where the bullets were flying.
And I'm like, my daughters. And I remember looking over to a guy that was sitting in a corner for cover as well, saying, my kids, my son's in the crèche at the front.
Detectives have made some progress finding the possible murder weapon.
It's been found in a burnt-out vehicle that was police were alleged was used in the murder, so it's highly likely.
The bullet holes and a lone security guard are all that remains as evidence of what happened here the other night. Inside, staff are trying to clean up and get ready for business again as police do their best to try and hunt down those who were responsible.
I'm scared to stay at home. I know they're not after me, but I can't help but feel scared. I really do.
And no one should have to feel like that. Steve Hart for 10 News First.